Okay. So, hi everyone. Welcome to yet another session for Cyber Preserve. Today we have Swapnil Mengi for another amazing session. He'll be taking session on MITRE attacks. So, I'll hand over the session, the mic to Swapnil. So, let's get started.
Sure. Hi. Hi everyone. You might have to enable the screen share.
Okay, just give me one minute.
No worries. Yeah, I think I've got it now.
Okay, cool.
Just give me a second. Okay, perfect. So, hi everyone. We'll be looking at MITRE today, and in very particular, we'll be looking at MITRE attack framework. So, apart from just MITRE attack, we'll be looking at a few more frameworks, but we'll be just going through them. We will not be looking through them in detail. So, to begin with, we have an introduction to MITRE, a very brief introduction to what MITRE is. We'll be looking at threat-informed defenses. How do threat-informed defenses work? What exactly is it? Different components within threat-informed defense. We'll be jumping to attack framework. What exactly is framework, the attack framework? We'll be looking at different tactics within the framework, different techniques. We'll be understanding the differences between tactic, techniques, and procedures. We'll be looking at how to make attack actionable in particular. How do we utilize attack and make it useful for us? How do we operationalize it? So we'd be looking at a concept called adversary emulation and a very brief case study that I had worked upon in 2020. So what exactly is MITRE? So MITRE is a non-for-profit organization which works in public interest. A couple of offering that MITRE has and are very are known to the public are CVEs and attack framework. So CVEs is something we talk about very frequently. Attack is something which has off late started picking up. So attack stands for adversary tactic, techniques, and common knowledge. We'll be looking at it in detail. Apart from this, MITRE works in different areas. It works in defense, intelligence, aviation, etc. So now one of the key points when we talk about MITRE is threat-informed defense. What are threat-informed defense? And anybody who's looking to build threat-informed defenses, MITRE becomes a key aspect in the whole framework. So threat-informed defense basically is understanding an adversary tradecraft and technology to protect against and detect certain cyber attacks. We understand an adversary's tradecrafts, technology, how does an adversary work, and we apply that understanding or knowledge to defend or detect certain cyber attacks. Now, three pillars for threat-informed defense are cyber threat intelligence analysis, defensive engagement of a threat, and focus sharing and collaboration. So now what exactly is cyber threat intelligence analysis? So cyber threat intelligence analysis is basically gathering certain TTPs, certain indicators, and utilizing them for hardening cyber defenses. You know, it goes beyond just the virus definitions to identify certain signatures, certain tactics, techniques, procedures, and different indicators to improve ways to anticipate, prevent, and detect cyber attacks. Now, MITRE particularly has something known as MITRE CRITS, which is Collaborative Research into Threats. It's a framework, it's an open source platform which provides different indicators, malware concerning indicators. It's a web service. You can go onto it, gather threat intelligence. It's an open source way to gather intelligence regarding a certain threat. Now, defensive engagement of a threat. defensive engagement of a threat particularly can be seen as something like a red team activity, something like a purple team activity, or in a very simpler form, a way to use the threat intelligence analysis that we've gathered to look for certain indicators within our network or utilize those indicators within our network to harden our defenses, to analyze our defenses. Now, focus sharing and collaboration is another key factor, which is key is in not just building threat-informed defense, but to deal with defense as a deal with threats as a community overall. So there are open standards such as STIX, TAXI, which can be utilized to share the indicators, consume the indicators, and at the same time, build defenses against them. Again, MITRE has one more offering called Center for Threat-Informed Defense, where different organizations, different people come together to research different threats. They build upon the MITRE attack framework. And this is something any organization or individual can utilize to perform research, to build defenses, or to deal with certain threats. Now, we've talked enough about threat-informed defenses. And one of the terms that we've talked about very frequently is attack framework. Now, what exactly is attack framework? So attack framework is a collection of different tactics, techniques that are used by attackers in a breach. So in a simple language, it's a cyber kill chain. So it is a matrix which consists of different tactics. Within different tactics, we have different techniques, and there are different procedures to implement certain techniques, to execute certain techniques. As a very basic example, we have initial access. So initial access can be termed as a tactic which is utilized to gain foothold within a network. So there will be certain techniques such as phishing, use of valid accounts, etc., to gain initial access or initial foothold within a network or an organization. We can look at execution. Execution is another tactic, and techniques within execution will be something like use of PowerShell, use of command interpreters to execute certain pieces of code within a network. We can look at persistence, which makes sure the connection connection within a particular organization or network maintains throughout the reboots, throughout different operations that an end user might perform. So techniques like registry or auto runs can be utilized to maintain persistence. You can look at privilege escalation, which is another tactic. And techniques within privilege escalation can be something like use of exploitation of certain vulnerabilities to elevate privileges. Defense evasion, another tactic which is utilized to avoid detections within a particular environment. And a great example of this would be DLL sideloading, turning off the defense mechanism as a whole. Credential access is another tactic, and some techniques within credential access would be credential dumping. Moving on, we have discovery as a tactic. So now post-exploitation, if the threat actor performs certain recon, for an example, within the network, that can be termed as discovery. They can try to discover the applications running within the network. That could be one of the techniques. Now, once a threat actor has access within the network, they might want to move laterally within the network to different systems or systems with different value. So high value systems, they might want to move towards, for an example, DC, which is a high value target for them. So they can utilize existing vulnerabilities to move within the network. They can utilize remote services to do that. Now, once the lateral movement has happened, there is another tactic called collection, where the threat actor can basically collect high value artifacts. They can collect files from local systems. They can collect files from network shares, for example. These can be some of the tactics. Now, control and command is something an adversary would use to communicate with the end system. Some common softwares like CobaltStrike is a great example of command and control. Web services can be a great tactic within command and control. Exfiltration is a tactic used to exfiltrate data out of a particular network and impact, obviously, once the whole kill chain or once the whole attack has come through. Impact is something that can be utilized to sort of disrupt these services for an organization or compromise their integrity. Some techniques within Impact can be encryption of systems, wiping off of disks, etc. Now, while these are the tactics, what exactly, in a simpler language, what exactly is a tactic and how do they map against the techniques and what are procedures? So tactics are an adversary's technical goals, and techniques are the ways to achieve those goals, and procedures are specific implementations of a particular technique. So to understand this better, a technique can be initial access, and a tactic can be initial access, and the technique within initial access can be, for example, phishing. And a procedure to perform phishing can be a very specific implementation of phishing. For an example, if you'll go to the MITRE ATT&CK website and you'll try to explore different tactics, techniques, and procedures within them, you can very simply find out that different procedures can be listed down as different threat actor groups. That is because they have a very specific implementation of a particular technique. To understand this in a non-technical form, I will simply try and understand it as, for an example, if I have to visit a place X, that's a tactic, that's a goal I want to achieve. I want to visit a place X. Now, a technique to achieve that tactic would be, I could take a cab, all right? I could walk to that place, I could ride a bicycle to that place. These will be the techniques, and different techniques can be common across different tactics. Now, to understand the procedure within these techniques can be a little tricky. So to understand it in a simpler form, if I want to go to a place X using a cab, I can utilize something like a Google map, which will be a specific implementation of a technique to achieve a certain target or a tactic. Now, moving forward from ATT&CK framework, ATT&CK gives us, MITRE ATT&CK gives us something known as a ATT&CK navigator, which is a simple Excel sort of an implementation, a web-based Excel implementation of different tactics and techniques. So this helps us basically navigate through different tactics and techniques, or map different techniques for different actors and research on them. So for an example, when we go through the use case, we'll be looking at it in more detail. But I could take a particular threat actor, map its techniques here. Then I could take another threat actor and map its techniques here and weigh their techniques. So when I weigh them, the common techniques can become high priority for me to defend, to test my defense or to prevent certain attacks. Now, how do we make ATT&CK more actionable? How do we utilize what we've learned so far and use in our day-to-day operations? So MITRE particularly provides a lot of intelligence data which can be utilized, but we'll be looking at certain specific tabs or certain specific factors. So threat intelligence as an example, we can look at different threat actor groups within MITRE ATT&CK framework, which gives us a very good idea as to what techniques a threat actor utilizes, what softwares a threat actor utilizes, and these can be utilized or these can be researched in order to work our way towards the defenses. We can, for an example, a threat actor utilizes phishing. So we can understand that, okay, a major initial access for this particular threat actor would be phishing. What we can do is take that, put that into our defenses, understand how can we defend against phishing, start making the users more aware against phishing, run user awareness campaigns. That would be a great example of this. You can utilize threat groups page to understand different threat groups or perform or map different threat groups against your organization in particular. So for an example, an organization sitting in India should be targeting or should be looking at Chinese-based threats or Chinese actors. An organization sitting in USA should be looking at Russian-based threats or Russian-based threat actor groups to defend against certain techniques or defend or build defenses against certain actors. Now, we've looked at ATT&CK MITRE, which is again a great way, and we'll be looking at this in more clarity once we get to the use case. Now, one of the outcomes or one of the ways to operationalize MITRE is perform adversary emulation. So you can utilize the knowledge you've gained for a particular adversary. You can apply that to your defenses and you can gain knowledge from that. So it becomes an infinite loop, never-ending loop, which basically means you will gain intelligence about a particular threat actor or a particular operation. You will use those tactics to build your defenses or test your defenses against them. And once you've tested your defenses, you can go ahead, use that knowledge to build your defenses or strengthen your defenses. And for this, you can utilize something like a MITRE CAR, cyber analytics repository, which gives you a great deal of analytics that can be utilized for certain MITRE techniques. You can utilize to particularly perform adversary emulation, you can utilize something like a atomic red team, something like Caldera. These solutions ideally let you test certain techniques, give you a result against them. And once you have a metric for a particular operation or a threat, you can utilize or map it against your organization and understand the exposure to a certain threat. So if we particularly look at APT3 emulation plan, you can use divided into three phases, phase one, two, and three. In phase one, you can set up the whole infrastructure. You can set up the whole software of the files, you know, the techniques that you'll be utilizing. You can use this knowledge that we've gathered through threat intelligence analysis to test our defenses, to perform certain operations or execute certain techniques. While we do that in phase two, the outcome of that can be fetched into phase three. We can utilize phase three to collect certain data, to compress, to exfiltrate data. And as a whole, we can utilize the outcome of the whole emulation that we do within a network to build or strengthen our defenses. For an example, a particular technique was executed successfully and went undetected. This can be that we can build certain defenses against it, or we can build certain detections against it. So if a threat actor tries to perform certain operations or certain techniques, execute certain techniques within the network, we have a detection in place, if not a defense against it. So now this is not a very exhaustive list, but a list of certain resources that are available within MITRE that you can utilize or use to study ahead. Apart from this, there are different frameworks. We can utilize MITRE Shield, which gives us active defenses against certain techniques. We can utilize MITRE Defend, which gives us countermeasures to utilize against threats. And before we end it, I'll just open the case study and walk you through the, a case study that I wrote in 2020 as to how do you defend against, not a very exhaustive case study, but then again, gives a pretty good idea as to how do we utilize MITRE to perform research or to perform certain to emulate certain threats. Okay, so as an example, what I did is I took five threat groups, Chinese threat groups that I could map the tactics for, and utilize this to understand what techniques will be important if dealing with Chinese threats. And this is particularly when the whole situation between India and China was a little escalated. So I took five APT groups, many of us, APT-19, APT-40, APT-41, and APT-3. Again, I took them from MITRE ATT&CK, from within MITRE ATT&CK framework. If we'll click on one of these, it'll give us a very exhaustive detail on a particular threat group. It'll give us different techniques it utilizes. It'll give us different softwares it utilizes, different procedure it utilizes in particular. So what I've done is I've taken Attack Navigator to map all the attack techniques for a particular threat group. Now, when I say I've taken up five threat groups, I have weighed every technique for every one of them as one. So for an example, if spear phishing attachment is used by all of them, the score for spear phishing attachment would become 5. And similar way, if you know, something like a trusted relationship and initial access is just utilized by one of them, it will be scored as 1. So I can prioritize my defenses or prioritize the way I look at how a threat actor might try to enter an organization or enter a network. And a result of the whole mapping was I could identify that spear phishing attachment can be one of the top utilized initial access methods, which is very true. If we go back at 2020, spear phishing attachment or phishing in particular was very heavily utilized by threat actors. If we look at execution, PowerShell becomes one of the top utilized techniques by these threat actors. So similarly, if we go through different tactics, we'll be able to get a very fair idea as to what techniques are heavily utilized for these threat actors. And what we can do is we can utilize this to build defenses. As a next step, you can utilize spear phishing attachment or phishing. You can perform phishing assessments. You can, if you see there are, you know, failures within the phishing assessments, you can have a user awareness campaign run within an organization to make users a bit more aware as to what phishing exactly is. If you look at execution, phishing PowerShell becomes one of the top utilized techniques. We can test PowerShell within an environment and see if it is being detected. If it is not being detected, we can build certain defenses or certain detections around it. And we can utilize, as I said, we can utilize something like a cyber analytics repository, which MITRE offers, to use certain use cases to understand how to build analytics or how to build detections around a particular technique. Persistence, registry, run key, startup folder, again, one of the very utilized technique within the attack chain or attack chain. So again, gives us a fair idea as to how do we prepare, what techniques do we prepare against, what techniques should we look at first, gives a prioritization metrics, gives us an idea as to what techniques should be, you know, if not defended, should be detected at the least. And using this, just this metric, we can understand what should be our priorities, what should we looking at for a given scenario. And I think that is it.
Okay, cool. That was really a very insightful session. Thank you so much, Swapnil.